Hello, I'm Alex Simonin, I'm a Swiss neurosurgeon, and today I will demonstrate how MedVR can assist with the surgical planning of a patient with a C3 lesion. So this patient is a 40-year-old female that presented with cervical pain over the last few weeks, and she's known for a breast cancer. We will review the images in two dimensions of the cervical spine. So on the CT slices in two dimensions, we can see that this patient has multiple cervical spine lesions that destroy the bone in the C3, C5 cervical vertebral bodies. So now I look at this patient's scan in VR, and obviously she was placed in a collar at the moment of the scan. I can place her cervical spine in any position and go through her structures with the intersect tool. I can clearly observe the vertebral bodies involved. The C2, C3, C5 vertebral bodies are involved. There is also a change in the sagittal alignment of those vertebral bodies with the segmental kyphosis at the C3 level. With this virtual reality, I can clearly observe the different anatomical structures involved and ultimately plan my surgical approach and define a surgical plan in order to stabilize the spine of this patient. So I like to use MedVR because it's quick and easy to engage. I can tailor and rehearse my surgical approach, and I can position the patient in any plan in order to clearly define my surgical approach. So now I use MedVR to check the postoperative scan of this patient. So we did a 360 stabilization with a corpectomy, a plate, and I can see here the position of my cage and the plates, the screws. And obviously we did also a posterior approach. I can even see here the staples, and we placed lateral mass and pedicle screws with rods, and I can appreciate all the hardware that we put from the back, from the front, and I can use any plan to see the alignment of the spine, which has been reduced now. So as you can see, MedVR is an easy tool to use in a daily practice. It is useful, and I think it's a great tool for young surgeons or surgeons in general to make an accurate 3D representation of the pathology. For example, in this spine disease, we could make a very accurate 3D representation of the pathology, the spine, the alignment of the spine, and tailor our approach, the screws that were put, the hardware, and check the final results. There is no doubt that VR will be an integrated tool for daily practice for the new generation of surgeons.